In 1518, a town nearly danced itself to death. I'm Jason Horton, and this is Strange Year. The Dancing Plague, July 1518. You're probably familiar with the Black and Bubonic Plague, but for 2 months in 1518, hundreds of citizens in Strasbourg, now northeastern France bordering Germany, danced uncontrollably and apparently unwilling for days on end, which was best known as the Dancing Plague. In July 1518, a woman whose name was given as Frau Truffa stepped into the street and began dancing. She seemed unable to stop and continued dancing until she collapsed from exhaustion. After resting, she resumed. She continued this way for days, and within a week, more than 30 other people were also affected. They kept dancing long past the point of injury. City authorities were alarmed by the ever-increasing number of dancers. The political and religious leaders theorized that more dancing would be the solution, so they arranged for guild halls for the dancers to gather in, musicians to accompany the dancing, and professional dancers to help the affected continue dancing. This only made it worse, and as many as 400 people were eventually consumed by the dancing compulsion. A number of them died from exhaustion. The mania seemed to dissipate by September. The 1518 event was the most thoroughly documented and probably the last of several outbreaks in Europe, which took place largely between the 10th and 16th century. Current explanations for the dancing plague included demonic possession and overheated blood. Investigators in the 20th century suggested that the affected might have been consumed bread made from rye flour and contaminated with the fungal disease ergot, which is known to produce convulsions. American sociologist Robert Bartholomew suggested that the dancers were adherents of heretical sects dancing to attract the divine favor. The most widely accepted theory was from American medical historian John Waller, who laid out in several papers his reason for believing that the dancing plague was a form of mass psychogenic disorder. Outbreaks took place under circumstances of extreme stress and generally take form based on local fears. In the case of the Dancing Plague of 1518, Walter cited a series of famines and the presence of such diseases as smallpox and syphilis as the overwhelming stressors affecting residents of Strasbourg. He further suggested that there was a local belief that those who failed to worship Saint Vitus, who was a patron saint of epileptics and dancers, would be cursed by being forced to dance. Similar manias took place in Switzerland, Germany, and Holland, though fewer as large or as deadly as the Dancing Plague of 1518. I want to thank Britannica.com and History.com. If you're a Spotify user, please search Strange Year and hit that follow button so you'll know when new episodes come out. And wherever you're listening, if you can rate and review 5 stars, it'd be very helpful. And if you have any suggestions or would like to message me, you can do so on Instagram at Strange Year Pod. Thank you so much for listening, and I'll be back next week for another episode of Strange Year.